Again, this is part two of the video where I made the mistake in the connecting rod. So once again, full disclosure, I'm going to show you, you'll see the mistake. I drilled all the way through 5/32 drill on the grub screw end of the connecting rod. I'm going to show you how I fixed that. So if you're following along, as this is your guide, do not drill 5/32 all the way through. Follow the plans. Now, let's continue with building the connecting rod.
Now I'm ready for my reamer, and for my reamer I'm going to put just a little bit of tap magic on the reamer. Okay, I've got my reamer in, I've got it oiled up. Now I'm going to take my parallels out because I don't want to ram that reamer up against one of those parallels. Actually, I believe that was back far enough where it won't get in. Alright, so that's a 1/4-inch hole. That should fit the crankshaft. Now I'll chamfer it with my hand. I'm not going to chamfer it in the drill press. I'll just use the deburr to do that. Now I'm going to go ahead and get these in here. Put some tension on them, just slightly. I don't want to bow it up. I just want to get some slight tension. And go ahead and tighten these down because I don't want to raise it up, but I don't want it to be pressed down either. So now I've got to come over and we'll get that one lined up. Now normally I would go in on this axis right here, so I've already centered it up with the wiggler, and I'm going to go ahead and get ready now to put the hole in it. This is supposed to be out at 5/32, and I don't have a 5/32 reamer. So I'm going to start it off with an 1/8-inch bit and just go up just a drill bit at a time until I get to 5/32. Sometimes somebody will comment about why do I go in and then come back out and then press the drill bit in a little bit more. Well, there's a couple of reasons for that. One, I don't have the very best drill bits in the world. These are import drill bits. Occasionally, if I have an opportunity, I will buy U.S. drill bits or British drill bits, something of better quality. But often, I'm not using a good drill bit, so drill bits have a tendency to wander. Now, I do keep these pretty sharp, but I like to go in and come back out, go in and come back out, and give it a chance to start a few times in there in case it's going off a little bit. All right, so I believe, I forgot what this drill bit was, but I got to bring it up to 5/32, so I'm going to get the next size up and continue to bring it up. That was a 1/8 I just did. This is a 9/64, and this is a USA bit here. But I'm just going to come up a little bit at a time because, like I say, I don't have a 5/32 reamer. So I'm using this. And if you don't have a reamer, just use this right here. It works pretty good. The step drill method, it works pretty good. Now you notice on that one, I don't have to start stop. That hole is already made. All the starting and stopping that I would do right there, if that hole was crooked, it's not going to straighten it out. I've just got to live with whatever it is, but it's straight. So that was 9/64, I believe. So next one's going to be the 5/32, which is the final size. All right, so this is my final one. I'll go ahead and slick it up just a little bit, and we'll punch her through.
Okay, one of the first things I wanted to do before I took a whole lot out was just see how we are on that crankshaft. And as you can see, I don't know if you can see it right now or not, let me zoom in a little bit. I am actually rotating that on the crankshaft. Now it's a really good, nice fit. Of course, remember, this is dry. That's what we're looking for. We're looking for a fit that's not going to knock, and I think that looks pretty good. And theoretically, the top part should be parallel with the bottom. And now I'm looking just to see how did we hit center on both sides. And I'm looking at that. That looks pretty centered. And then on the back side, looks pretty centered also. So at this time, I feel confident enough to take it out of the vise, put all that apart, and now I'm going to do some hand chamfering. Let me get that. And what I'll do here is just run this in a few times, just to kind of clean up those outside rough edges a little bit. Make that look a little bit nicer. And the top part. Nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. All right, so there's one more operation to do, and that is come back and just mill this part here out. Okay, do a little third grade math here because I wouldn't have a clue what 6 millimeters is, but I refer back to one of my little pocket guides right here. And for you guys over on the metric side, sometimes I envy you, but it's too old for this dog to learn new tricks. So I'll just go ahead and do some conversion. So this inside of this, the little horseshoe is going to go down. The plans call for 6 millimeters. Well, if I look that up in my book right here, that's plus or minus 237 thousandths. Well, I don't have a 237 thousandths mill. So what I'm talking about here is you use what you have within reason. So I don't have a 237 thousandths mill, but guess what? Everybody in a machine shop's got a quarter inch. Well, a quarter inch is 250 thousandths. So if I'm looking for 237, I'll subtract that, I get 13 thousandths. Now, that's 13 thousandths that I'm off. But this is going to be split side to side. So, you know, I guess you could say if it went all the way over to one side, I'd have 13 thousandths play. But in reality, this is going to be floating in the middle. So, and I'm going to have a part right here and a part right there that comes in. And, you know, if it goes to one side, sure, I'm 13 thousandths of slack. But the reality is, it's probably going to be riding more or less in the middle. So that's 6.5 thousandths. I can live with 6.5 thousandths play side to side, because even if it was at 237 thousandths, it's going to have you know, probably 10,000 play right there. So I'm only increasing the play a little bit on that. And again, this is a hobby engine. It's not going to do any work. That's not going to cause any extra noise. Not going to cause a knock. You won't even be the, you won't be able to see the 6,000 difference per side. So that's what I'm talking about. You got to do what you can do with what you got. Now the outside is a little different. The outside is going to be 12 millimeters. So outside to outside is going to be 12 millimeters. So that's plus or minus 472,000. It's in that neighborhood. Now this is 540,000 side to side. So that's 68,000. That might be a problem because that's 34,000 a side. So what I'll do is, since that's the outside, that's what a file is for. There's nothing here that has to be. I can file that and you won't notice it. In fact, wherever this engine right here is, the part that we're talking about is that part right there, which is hidden up inside the engine. So let's go ahead and go to the milling machine and get this set up, and we'll see what it looks like.